already on death row for one murder, pleads guilty to another he's accused of.
This morning, Clyde Gibson admitted to killing Karen Hodella in 2002 in exchange for a 65-year sentence. WLKY's Marissa Alter is live outside the Floyd County Courthouse with the developments. Marissa?
Vicki, Gibson didn't address the court at all during today's plea hearing, but he did make a different kind of statement with a new controversial tattoo on the back of his head.
For the first time since November, when Judge Susan Orth sentenced Clyde Gibson to death, the 57-year-old returned to her Floyd County courtroom, this time to plead guilty to a different murder. Karen Hodella disappeared in 2002, her body later washed up on the shores of the Ohio. The case remained cold for nearly a decade until Gibson's arrest for the murder and mutilation of his mother's friend, Christine Whitus. During the interrogation, police say he admitted to the Hodella case. We spoke with Hodella's sister shortly after.
He's a sick man. He really is a sick man.
Gibson is already on death row for Whitus's murder, and prosecutors will seek the death penalty when they go to trial for the murder of another woman, Stephanie Kirk. Investigators found her body buried in Gibson's yard. Hodella's case was the only one in which prosecutor Keith Henderson didn't file for the death penalty.
I chose not to. When we reviewed these cases in 2012, you know, based on the age, the facts and circumstances.
It's also the only Gibson case Henderson's office negotiated on. In exchange for a guilty plea, Gibson got the maximum time behind bars, 65 years. Plus, the conviction can't be brought up during the Kirk trial. Prosecutors previously said Gibson has a tattoo on his arm of a knife with a date, 10-10-02, the day they believe he killed Hodella. Thursday, he showed off a new tattoo, this one on the back of his shaved head. It says, death row times three.
That has been addressed by the court. That will be an issue for a trial. And
the concern is the tattoo would prejudice the jury in the Kirk case. Judge Orth has issued a motion so Gibson's hair grows in and covers the ink.
He can't get a haircut. And so it's my understanding that when he shaves in the morning, they make sure he doesn't shave his head.
Floyd County Sheriff says there's no way Gibson got that tattoo in his jail, where he's kept in isolation.
But Clyde Gibson was in a cell, I repeat, by himself.
Jailers say they discovered the tattoo when he returned to Floyd County a week ago.
When I spoke to him, he said that he had received it while he was at the Department of Corrections. He seemed that he had a purpose for getting it.
And what that purpose was, Gibson didn't say. The judge has also asked the sheriff not to release any pictures of the tattoo. We will get another look at it on April 17th. That's when Gibson is set to be formally sentenced for this case. Also, Henderson says that the Kirk case is on trial, is on track, rather, to go forward in June. Reporting live in New Albany, I'm Marissa Alter, WLKY News.